Well, folks, this is the second time I've had this 310K 2014 John Deere backhoe in there. The first time I put a new charge pump in it, and that did allow the gears to shift. One thing was the actual gears were weak, all but reverse and first gear. So this next time, I'm just gonna take the trans out. I bought all the plates and steels. Some from John Deere, some from Amazon, some from eBay. Basically chose the cheapest path out as far as the same part number, the same John Deere, everything. Just trying to get this old hoe to hold fast, pushing dirt up and going down the road. So I'll post some more videos to come like I did last time. I mean, I just blocked up the front and the rear, as you can see. And first thing I'll do is disconnect the drive shafts, unplug the solenoids, and then I'll get into the draining portion, which is drain out the actual the automatic transmission and then drain the hydraulic reservoir. That's why I've got this block, just in case it does leak down. You know, I'll still have my equipment in the air service in order to service that trans. So anyways, I'll follow up. So you remove that hose clamp. Pull that hose off. That allows all of your fluid to come out and land in a Rubbermaid tote. Next thing you need to do is take the U-joint covers off the axles, front and rear on this back axle. And if you got a four-wheel drive, you take your front yokes off and you'll just drop this down and slide it out of the transmission. So also drain the transmission fluid pan, which is right here. So I'll try to video this while I get this piece out. Let's see if I can zoom out. Yeah. Okay, here we go. A little pry tool, really. There we go. Drive shaft is out. Just like on a Silverado or a Jeep. And then you just slide that off. There's your front drive shaft. Same thing with the rear one. So I took the back yoke. You see over there, it just slides off those splines. And then the four bolts out of this back part of the drive shaft, which it's laying out there. And then I just now took that bolt out up here on the top, on the left and the right. That is the hydraulic pump. That's the hose for the hydraulic pump. That's the output line, and then that's a drain line. You have to actually take that line off, go into that cooler to get that elbow off, which will allow the transmission to slip from this position now, mount it to the machine, and then back away from the machine to get it out. So you got to take that one out. I did take the flex bolts out, which kind of done a lot of things in about 30 minutes, but I just take a pry tool here and then turn the flywheel here to get to these actual bolt locations. One's right here and there's three other ones. So that's four bolts in total. Took both of these lines loose. Haven't slipped them out yet to let them drain, but plan to do that. And next steps will be taking these bell housing bolts out. Ratchet strapping underneath here again to where it holds the engine up. Taking the motor mounts out, taking the solenoid wires off on the top side, these two, that line there, and then that line there. Got to take those two lines off and be looking at it, ready to come out just about. Oh yeah, and the infamous dipstick. That thing is a pain in the butt to get to, but anyway, here we are.
solenoids are unplugged, which there's three of them there. The sensor that goes onto the hydraulic pump is unplugged. Took the elbow off of the cooler unit. Took one bolt out of the bottom of the mount hanger on each side. Loosened that one because it won't come out due to the rail being in the way. Took this line off. Took the top line off and the two side lines off. I like the dipstick bracing underneath. And then the rest of these bell housing bolts. And that should be it. And I'll put my jack under here and wheel it back and hopefully get her on out and put a new, all new clutch packs in it. Say hey, Sandy. Hey there. Duke, what you doing? Duke, what you doing, boy? Okay, you want some lip out. So we've got all of the bell housing bolts out from the top and the bottom. Everything's disconnected. The last thing is these motor mounts on both sides. Best thing to have is these little Craftsman lights. Not pitching for Craftsman tool parts, but my girlfriend came in clutch with these. And they can see real good. Help me a lot. So I'm gonna take these last bolts out. I'm gonna try to lower it down. I might have to take that arm off over there so it'll come on back. But other than that, we're about ready. Well, folks. Got both the bolts out of the side, motor mounts, transmission mounts, and all the bell housing bolts have been disconnected. She's ready to roll back. Not sure exactly how I'm gonna do that with a video, but probably not. Camera right back. I'm really hoping it captures everything, but make sure I zoom it out there. As far as it can be, I'll start letting this thing down. When a jack goes down, it goes forward, so me to stop right there. I need to roll it back just a tad. Check it. We are clear as a bell this time, which is awesome. All right. By Georgie coming down. All right, slowly. Sure, they don't want to rush the good part. She's coming on down. Let's see if I can roll it back just a tad more. There we go. All right, now we're getting into a little bit of a lean situation. That kind of scares me. And that fixed the lean. Just need a little room. If you had a jack that went straight up and straight down, wouldn't have to really worry about the whole lean portion of this. Alright. that plate up there rubbing on something. We're on ground level nearly. Let's see if I can get it down just a tad bit more. So we're just about bottom. Right there is about as far as I can go. Alright, let me roll it on out. This is gonna require a buddy, so I'm gonna probably leave it like it is tonight. I've done plenty of work after work tonight. I have to have somebody help me set this thing down and or put a winch on it or something and let it fall down. It's not controlled like. But that's it, folks. That's how you drop a trans out of a 310 John Deere backhoe. 2014 model. It's a new one, but it may be pretty simple. First step is to put the torque converter and flex plate in the total tank. It's really kind of a challenge to get it back down on there, but take it off the engine. You just pull up, you got it. There'll likely be some fluid coming out of there. If it hadn't already. And now, you just got,
I don't know how many. Well, you take all the bolts out, and then take your little dead blow hammer, tap on it, and it comes right off. That's the bell housing part. Next piece is taking all of these bolts out around the edges to get that top piece to come off. So you take all the bolts out around the sides, put two bolts in with a little engine puller. Jack it up, tap on the sides, and it separates. And this is what you're left with. All your transmission clutches. And then you go through them, and I'll get into that later. But there's where we are. So I use this puller here, this jaw top puller, an impact with 11/16. Pull that bearing off of this shoulder right here after I took the sealing ring. I took this sealing ring off first, which is very small and will break very easily. Take it off first, take the bearing off. Once you take the bearing off, and this whole piece right here comes up. I'm not sure exactly what it's called, but that slides up. There's needle bearings inside there. Be very careful. And then take this retaining ring off the top of the top plate. And then there's your clutches. That's a clutch and a steel and a clutch steel, clutch steel, clutch steel, and then some kind of a bearing, something other. But the clutch actually looks pretty good. I mean, this is what it's supposed to look like, but it, you know, it's not smooth like I was thinking. What seems to have wear on it is the actual plates, and they might have worn the tolerance down to where they won't actually grip when you engage that gear. So that's it. This is the last clutch, the first speed clutch. I just took it apart, and that's the one that was failed, burned up completely. The rest of them were pretty well fine. Didn't have much slack in this ring right here that holds the that top plate down, which would be this piece. Apparently the first gear has to work with the other gears to get the high and the low to work correctly as well. So I'm rebuilding the whole transmission as far as every clutch plaque, and I guess I only might have had to only do one, but I'm going to have a bulletproof, hopefully, transmission for quite a while. So I'll show you the process. I'm gonna try to set you up right here and see how it's rolling. Oh, maybe that won't fall. But basically what I do is I take a clutch disc and I get it good and soaked in Hi-Guard, which is the OEM fluid. I put in a seal. I put in a clutch. Put in another seal. Put in this clutch. Put in another seal. So you get the process. It's basically steel clutch, steel clutch, steel clutch until you get to however it's designed to go into each one of these clutches. So once you get all that, basically loaded into the clutch pack, you can go to the reassembly portion. I think I've mentioned this in a couple of earlier videos. Make sure they're stuck together. But we'll go back with everything that was on top of it. So basically, everything inside this hub and the gear, you know, that drives it, it's mounted to this hub with the bearings on the inside, and it's got throwout bearings. They all kind of fall together, just like a jigsaw puzzle, except it's not so hard. But yeah, once you get the clutch rebuilt, you just put everything back the way you found it, and make sure you put your sealing ring back on, which those suckers are tricky. When I say tricky, they can break easily on you. They can, you know, be a pain when you're putting it back together. As to, you know, if they fail, you're not going to build pressure in your trans, and that's going to cause you to have a pressure failure, and that clutch pack won't engage or disengage. So, I'm no professional. Just taking mine. I'm doing this on my kitchen countertop. Okay. I just know a little bit about my.
Guys, you just take this Loctite High Flex gasket maker and you put it all the way around the bead, clean both surfaces, and then use brake cleaner to clean or some sort of cleaner, like acetone. Clean both sides and you'll flip this over and then set it down over top of all that. Probably going to use the hoist for this, but that's where I'm at now. About to put it back together.
Well, when you see these dowel pins come up, that means she's down, everything's seated below. Gotta be real careful with these sealing rings around each one of these clutches. If you break a sealing ring, you lose all pressure. You lose pressure, you don't have shifting, you don't have a trans, you gotta take it back out. So be very careful when you put the this case back on it. And that's where we're at. She's down.
Little tip. If you can get those first four started close to the hub, it slips right over that pump housing. And you gotta do some whacking on it with this old orange dead blow hammer. Then after that, you can just start running these things up. There's a blue million of them. But they do go down easy once you get them started.
So the last step in assembling this transmission is getting this torque converter to slip back down, all the way down, to engage all three of the shafts and the torque converter hub into the pump that's located beneath that torque converter. So once you get it all the way down, kind of can be challenging there. You just got to line all the splines up, like the zip tie that flex plate to the housing, just in case in transit from here to the backhoe it might want to slip off. But I'll invert it vertically, and from that point
jack it back up into position, start the bolts, and then start the reassembly process the same way I took it out. So hopefully I have a follow-up video on YouTube with the actual backhoe doing work for me. So anyways, thank y'all for watching, and I really hope this helps somebody out there that's just like me, doesn't have any real good support and really don't want to spend the $7,000 or whatever it is to get this done, you know, by, you know, a shop that does this every day. I mean, I've got a little bit of common sense and some really good friends with some knowledge, so it's just been a kind of a learning process, and actually happy I got to know this much about my my backhoe. I was talking to somebody the other day. They were like, man, I bet it's been hard on you getting that done. I said, honestly, it's been kind of fun. I mean, learning about all this, you know, it is what it is. I got the backhoe at a good price, and I knew I was going to have to work on it, so glad it was, you know, something I could fix myself. So anyways, good luck to everybody. Thank you.